Tips on planning your own house and saving a fortune. Deciding to build your own house is a big decision and it does take time and lots of it. However, you can save loads of money if you build the house on your own. Remember, this does not mean that you can lay every brick in your house yourself. You will need people who are professionals, who know how to lay a brick. However, you can save money by managing them yourself. Here are a few tips. These tips are not technical in nature like how to build a house on your own, managing the laborers, carpenters and other professional people. These tips are related to mindset. Don't build your house that small. There is a tendency, after a person has had to put up with crowded quarters for a long time, that, when an opportunity comes to expand, instead of a reasonable and gradual expansion, something like an explosion occurs. We want to go all out for a bigger and better house, with expansive room, space for everything. Remember that every square foot costs money and has to be kept up. That snug, cozy, warm feeling that comes over one when he is seated with his family around his own brightly glowing fireplace may disappear if a house gets too large, particularly if it isn't paid for. House should fit family. The number and size of rooms needed in a house depend largely on the size of the family and the manner in which they are accustomed to living. In some parts of the world, a room 8 square is considered adequate for most purposes, and 2 or 3 such rooms make a complete livable house. Much depends on one's style of living and what the neighbors have is sometimes a consideration. Avoid cutting up a house into a large number of tiny cubicles for specific purposes. Remember, every wall costs money and will often be in the way. Moreover, our ideas of suitable activities are continually taking on new forms as we and the children grow older. We can't keep moving the partitions to keep up with our changing activities. It is a mistake to think that every different type of activity requires a separate and distinct room of its own. A given area can often serve efficiently for several different purposes at various times of the day and of the year. The types of activity that are interesting to a family will determine to a large extent the size of the room needed. If your favorite indoor sport is to read the newspaper, you do not need a very large room. You need even less space in which to read a magazine or book. A real bibliophile, however, needs a lot of shelves in which to keep his voluminous library. If you like to entertain with large parties, you will need a large, beautiful living room. In this country, every young couple wants a house that is exclusively its own. In many places of the world, a family is likely to include what we would call several families, including grandparents and several married children and their offspring. With a house for only 2 people, perhaps we can get along with a moderate amount of space. It is a mistake to build a house with only 1 bedroom, even for a couple without children who seldom have overnight guests, as such a house is hard to finance and is often difficult to sell. Select a lot where all the houses are approximately in the price class as the house that you want. Sometimes it is alright to build a little below your neighborhood if you are sure to make the house especially attractive in appearance. Where to get ideas? Where should a person look for ideas? Visit houses under construction and subdivisions near you. These houses will indicate the popular trends in your area. Many magazines are full of house plans and ideas for beautifying the home. The trouble with many of them is that they show only what is different or spectacular, and do not spend much time on the ordinary house for everyday living. There is more news value in the unusual, the bizarre, the different, and even the ridiculous, than in the things that you can live with right along. If you decide to get a mortgage, always use a mortgage calculator to save yourself money. Sadiq is a real estate investor for over 20 years, mostly in commercial real estate, especially shopping centers, hotels, motels. His real estate articles are a regular feature at trcb.com.